Fine, thank you. How are you, Chef Tom? And it's a pleasure to be speaking with you.
Well, thank you.
Thank you so much for visiting with Living Gourmet. I just wanted to say I'm speaking with Chef Tom Douglas, and you are a three-time James Beard Award recipient and a restaurateur. And thank you so much again.
Thanks for having me, Catherine. Happy holidays.
Thank you. Thank you. Merry Christmas to you. And you're here to tell us how to plan the perfect party without too much stress and fuss and get to actually get to enjoy the party as well.
Yeah, you don't want to be left out. You don't want to be stuck in the kitchen doing all the work while your friends and family are enjoying everything out front without you. So I always welcome them with a welcoming cocktail. I made a little sparkling wine spritzer, so to speak. I call it the cranberry fizz, and it's basically homemade cranberry syrup, a little cranberry bitters, and then I just put that in the bottom of the glass and slowly pour my sparkling wine in. I'm using the Domaine St. Michel Brut from the Yakima Valley, a beautiful wine valley here in Washington State, and I love that as an opening cocktail.
Well, that sounds delicious. Actually, you mentioned the cranberry syrup from the leftover Thanksgiving cranberry syrup. I just put that in my tea, and it's delicious.
In your tea, that's interesting.
So there are many good uses for that.
Yeah, exactly.
And you say about the guest list, the music playlist, which is very important for a good party,
mm-hmm.
and then you get to planning the menu. And when you plan your menu, can you give us some tips on how much, well, of course, it goes by how many you're having, but a lot of times people overbuy. Don't you find that?
Their wine?
For the wine and the food.
Food, yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I always plan on, if I think about the bottles of wine, I plan on about 6 glasses per bottle because you want people to kind of go through the wine that you've selected, both the white and the red and the bubbles. So you pour a little bit smaller pour and you let them have a little bit more variety. And in doing that, I plan that a week in advance so that I taste the wines that I'm gonna serve. Then I start to put together a menu in my head to make sure that the wine and the food are perfect matches. So when I was tasting this wine, the Eroica Riesling from Chateau St. Michel, I was thinking, God, I see a lot of citrus notes to it, a little bit of sweetness, nice acidity, it's versatile. I think it would go with a lot of different things. So I made a little savory appetizer out of melted leeks, perfect this time of year for leeks, roasted potatoes, cheese, and a little twist of tarragon to give me an aromatic quality that matches up well with this wine, and made empanadas. I made little cheesy leek empanadas. And the trick that I like to do with these empanadas, Catherine, is to, I make them all the way to here, right, all the way raw, into this part where I crimp them up, and then I just put them in the freezer. I can make these a week or a month in advance. So that day when I'm excited and nervous and all my friends are coming over and my office mates, I just pop these in the oven ready to go instead of having to make them. That way.
Oh, they sound delicious. So.
Yeah. And you know, you serve them at room temperature so that you're not burning your guests' hands as they're walking around with a glass of wine. So.
Exactly. And what else do you have on the menu that people can, you know, make ahead and stay out of the kitchen, as you say?
Yeah, exactly. So one of the things I made here today was a little fennel tart. You know, people are a little bit scared of fennel. They don't know quite what to do with it. This is an easy recipe. I put a little caramel in the bottom of my muffin tin, a couple of slices of fresh fennel, and a little dough topper, right, like that. And basically, that can go in the fridge for a couple of days or a couple of hours, your choice. And when I'm ready, about an hour before my guests arrive, I just put it in the oven, get ready to go, and then turn them out. And I end up with these cute little mahogany fennel tarts. Vegetarian.
Oh, I love fennel. I just love fennel, so I'm not afraid of it.
I know, exactly. But, you know, I'm sure you recognize that it's not the most popular vegetable, but it's so good.
It is delicious. Mm-hmm. And growing up in an Italian family, it was always put on the table at the end of the meal with nuts, and we all picked on the fennel and nuts at the end of a meal.
You know, my little My little fennel story is that my daughter, when she was teething in the restaurant, you know, I had to cook, so she would sit in her car seat in the restaurant, and I'd give her fennel because it would numb the gums of her gums while she was teething, and it made her feel good. To this day, she loves fennel. So.
Oh, I do too. And now, what else do you have for people who don't want to eat meat and people who are gluten-free and whatnot?
Right. So this could be made with gluten-free flour. So could the dough for the empanada. For those who don't want to eat meat, on this side, they're vegetarian. On this side, I did a seared steak so that the people that do like to eat meat and are looking for something a little more hearty to kind of hold down their cocktails and things. I just put a little slice of steak right on top. Because a lot of times holiday parties are not really sit-down dinners. Many times they're stroll-about kind of appetizer parties. And you have to have something to go with red wine, right? Because I have the Indian Wells Cabernet Sauvignon from Chateau St. Michel, and it's a rich, hearty red wine, and I want something rich and hearty to go with it. So both of those work.
That sounds wonderful. Now, do you have ideas, Dean? You say, you know, it's basically an appetizer party, which are a lot of fun because people do get to mingle and all, for a dessert table.
Oh, there's a million things you could do for desserts. Probably the easiest thing is like a little cream puff stuffed with a custard, a flavored vanilla custard or something like that would be an easy finish to this party.
Oh, that's right after my own heart. I just made cream puffs this weekend. And
thanks.
I love cream puffs because you can make the shells ahead of time, you make the cream, and then you just fill them when your guests come.
Exactly. Thank you, Catherine, for having me. I appreciate it.
Oh, I appreciate speaking with you, and I want to wish you the most happiest of Christmas and New Year.
Well, thank you. I certainly will. Bye-bye.
Thank you. Bye-bye.